Well, there's four tests for cardiovascular inflammation. That's because there isn't one good, simple, reliable yes or no test. To get great questions from viewers. This one's from Patrick Nabors. Thanks. Hello and thanks for the videos. You've been very helpful in working out my many questions. I have a question about this, the PLAC2 test. On the old PLAC test, I was getting high numbers, 230. Then I started taking Crestor and cut the carbs. Good work. That's what you need to do. Recently, I got a 118 on the PLAC2 activity test. There's a lot of disagreement in the range for this test. I see Cleveland Heart wants it under 75, but both you and my provider seem to say under 180 is good. Can you clarify this? I see that yours is 70. I'm hoping to continue bringing mine down, but while eating the Mediterranean diet, I had massive calcium buildup going on due to spiking blood glucose, which I was unaware of since fasting blood glucose and A1C were normal, 5.5. which I now know is very high. So, yep, it's always something, isn't it, Patrick? But you've already demonstrated, I think, one of the key things that most folks are not aware of, and that is there's more than one LPPLA2 test. Let's go back, and let me just say this. One of the golden rules is to look at the range on the test that you're using. Some labs have not switched over to the activity test. Some are still using the old MASS or ELISA test. Now, if that's beginning to sound like mumbo jumbo or a little bit complicated, let's go on and talk a little bit more about it, and I'll explain some of that. First of all, what is LPPLA2? If you're asking, here's what it is: lipoprotein-associated phospholipase A2. Now, what does that mean? What is it really? We'll cover that in just a minute. Bottom line, quick spoiler, it's an enzyme released by the macrophages, which is supposed to result in oxidation of LDL in the plaque. Now, even that is debated right now, whether or not it's an actor in causing inflammation or just a marker for inflammation. And the reality is, there's a debate on either side of this fence. There's no debate, however, that increased LPPLA2 is very much a sign of plaque activity, and even more so, what we would call thin-capped necrotic core plaque. Some people may be tempted to call that a plaque that's getting ready to pop, and that is exactly what it is. Now, there's been way too much research and going down a bunny hole of looking for that one plaque that's going to pop. The reality is there's not one. If you've got this process of inflammation, it's systemic and it's going on throughout the body, not just at one vulnerable plaque. And if you have a question about that vulnerable plaque discussion, again, I've got other videos on it. Go take a look. If one plaque, but the biochemistry is, if one plaque is vulnerable, all of them are. But what's the point behind that? Again, LPPLA2 is a marker for it. Is LPPLA2 actually causing some of that? Again, it's up for debate. Now let's get back to Patrick's question. He mentioned the activity assay, and that's a whole different kettle of fish. Actually, there are two different assays that are, or tests that are in battle for supremacy. There are multiple tests, even just for something like LPPLA2, test kits. Methods for measuring this enzyme, LPPLA2. The two biggest ones right now are a MASS test or a ELISA, E-L-I-S-A. ELISA stands for enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. So what you do is you put a marker on antibodies to this enzyme, LPPLA2. You then ferment or cook or leave the enzyme in with the immune markers. After you do that, you put them on a gel of electrophoresis. It's it's a technical discussion. And you see how much of the enzyme is linked to the antibody. That's one test. That's ELISA. That's the standard test up until about a year or two ago. And it became pretty clear to many labs, Mayo and Cleveland, for example, that an activity assay was better. A lot of these reasons were technical reasons. For example, you see this do not shake down here. There are issues in terms of the stability of the testing kit and testing process that the activity assay appears to be far superior in. So, again, we started at a high level with a very simple question. Then we got way deep and way complicated very quickly. Let's go back and just summarize real quick. And I'll cover another couple of studies, I think, later in other videos. But the bottom line is, what is PLAC2? What's the PLAC2 test? The PLAC2 test shows significant cardiovascular risk. Is it the only test? Why don't we just use that one test and not use a panel? Because, as you see, you know, there's an old lab analogy, and it's the same as an old treatment analogy for doctors as well. The lab analogy goes, why use four tests when there's one good one? Well, there's four tests for cardiovascular inflammation. That's because there isn't one good, simple, reliable yes or no test. The same thing goes for treatment. You know, when you see diseases where there's four or five treatments, that means there's no one good treatment. But let's get back to this question. So what is LPPLA2? It's an enzyme released by the macrophages or foam cells when they get involved with a plaque. It has been associated with thin-capped necrotic core plaques. In other words, what used to be thought of as vulnerable plaques, but again, as we know now, if you've got one vulnerable plaque, most of your plaques are vulnerable. This image actually came from an article where they were talking about agents to possibly even reduce the activity of PLAC2. Bottom line, what do you do, Mr. Nabors? Look at the normals or the cut points for average or normal or risk that are given to you by the lab itself. If you've made it this far through all that confusion, I'm impressed and thank you very much for your interest. I've had so many patients come to me because they quote their doc, here, why don't you take this statin and let's see what happens. What? Let's see if a heart attack or stroke happens. No. Prevention is a science. We know what's going to happen. We know what to look for. We know how to prevent it. Come see us in Louisville on November 8th and 9th. Get your CIMT, artery scan, all your labs, see me, and spend 2 days learning, usually what your doctor doesn't know yet about the science of prevention. Look forward to seeing you there. Thanks.